Hello, my name is Vijay Shah from the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. It's an honor and a privilege for me today to provide a video capsule of our recent work that was accepted into the Journal of Clinical Investigation, JCI Insight. And today I will give you a brief summary of the study. The background relating to this work focuses on the hepatic sinusoids in liver fibrosis. Under normal conditions, the liver vessels are in a quiescent state, and the cells that contribute to blood vessel regulation and fibrosis are also in a quiescent state. These cells are called hepatic stellate cells. In response to liver injury, these cells undergo a number of changes characterized by increased contractility, matrix deposition, and this leads to the process that we know is liver fibrosis and clinically manifested as liver cirrhosis with its complications of encephalopathy, ascites, and bleeding. However, the molecular mechanisms by which this happens aren't fully defined. That's where our study focused its efforts. Our prior work in this area focused on a glycoprotein called neuropilin-1. And neuropilin-1 plays a major role in regulating a number of growth factors and other receptors that contribute to this process of liver fibrosis. This is shown in the cartoon here. You can see where neuropilin-1 can contribute to the binding of a variety of ligands to their receptors and signal downstream to activate collagen deposition. However, a number of gaps remain from our prior paper in the Journal of Clinical Investigation a few years ago on this topic. Most notably, what were some of the signaling mechanisms that link neuropilin-1 with downstream processes and the receptors involved? With that in mind, we focused our current study on a protein called synectin, which is a scaffold protein and a binding partner of neuropilin-1. First, we did in vivo studies using mice which had genetic depletion of synectin from hepatic stellate cells. And this revealed that depletion of synectin using this approach attenuated liver fibrosis. To understand the mechanisms of this process, we performed RNA sequencing to look at the potential targets of synectin in hepatic stellate cells in cells that were depleted of synectin. This led to one specific target, which was PDGF receptor beta, which is very important in the process of liver fibrosis. In the first part of our study, we were able to show that synectin is important for regulation of PDGF receptor beta through a number of modifications of histone proteins, including the regulation of histone 3, lysine 27 acetylation, and histone 3 lysine 27 trimethylation. In the second part of our study, we focused on another PDGF receptor isoform, PDGF receptor alpha. And it turns out that synectin also regulates PDGF receptor alpha, however, through an entirely different mechanism. In this case, synectin maintains PDGF receptor alpha in active signaling endosomes to facilitate hepatic stellate cell migration and proliferation that's important for the development of liver fibrosis. On the other hand, there are specific lysine residues on PDGF receptor alpha that are ubiquitinated, and this can lead to their degradation through an autophagic pathway. And this was shown through a number of approaches, including mutant constructs and pharmacologic compounds. So this led us to our overall summary of what we were able to show in this study relating to how synectin can regulate PDGF receptor alpha and beta to regulate liver fibrosis. PDGF receptor alpha through its autophagic degradation, and PDGF receptor beta through transcriptional regulation, particularly epigenetic regulation by modulation of histone marks. And these processes in total are able to provide a molecular switch that regulates quiescent hepatic stellate cells into activated hepatic stellate cells and contributes to liver fibrosis. This work would not be possible without the talented team that's shown in this picture, especially Usman Yacoub, Sheng Cao, Mary Drenane, Haibing Liu, and others. as well as a number of collaborators, including Dev Mukhopadhyay, Mike Simons, Tatiana Kisileva, David Brenner, Raul Arudia, Alex Revzin, and Dan Schumperlin. So I thank you for listening to our capsule, and we hope that you found the material interesting for your own research, and hope you like the paper.